traveling around the world. Over the phone, dropping tears. I get more vulnerable when I do good. When you drunk, you tell me exactly how you.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. So today is June 14th. We are officially 10 days out. Today, I'm going to be taking you guys through a full day of eating. So I do have a refeed day today. Just to give you guys a little update. Yesterday, I saw my lowest weigh in all of prep at 158.6, which is crazy to me. I don't remember the last time I weighed under 160. My weight actually dropped 2.2 pounds from the day before. So my coach gave me a high day yesterday of 400 carbs. And today was even crazier. After the 400 grams of carbs, my weight went down again to, actually today's my lowest weigh-in. So today was 158.2, down 0.4 from yesterday. So honestly, I did not expect to see a new low weigh-in, especially after a high day. So sent my check-ins to my coach and I'll show you what he said.
All right, so as you guys can see, just sent my check-ins to my coach. So today we're going to stick with my same 400 gram carb day, but I don't know if you guys can read this.
But yeah, so today we have essentially the same high that I did yesterday of 400 carbs, but instead for my last meal, I'm doing a burger and fries. So yeah, not complaining about that. I remember the last time I had a burger and fries, but nah, I'm excited for today. I'm gonna take you guys through it, take you guys through my meals. And yeah, we're gonna get into meal one soon.
This is meal one. I made this in one of my most recent videos, but it is gonna be the protein oats cookie. So honestly, I've loved this during prep. Like, instead of my oats, sometimes I'll do this. It's literally the exact same ingredients. Oats, just isolate, water. So especially on my refeed days when I can add toppings like almond butter, blueberries, jam. Oh, it's so good. So
yeah, just gonna throw this in the air fryer and I'll show you guys how it turns out.
Oh my god, so excited for this. I love eating this. But yeah, so just to break everything down, it's 100 grams of oats, 20 grams of almond butter, 20 grams of jam, some cinnamon, some pink salt on top, and what else we got? 40 grams of isolate.
Look at that. Who said dieting had to be hard? Yeah, so gonna get through this. Got a nice black coffee as well. So meal one is down. Enjoyed that a lot. I listed the macros up on the screen for you guys. I'll list the macros for every meal throughout the day and my total calorie intake for the day. But yeah, I just wanted to touch base on, you know, refeed days or high days and the purpose behind them. So what is a refeed? So a refeed is a day where you essentially bump your carbs up, and the goal of a refeed is to replenish your glycogen stores in your muscles. So when you're, you know, you're on low calories, low carbs, doing a lot of cardio, you're depleting your muscles of glycogen. So in order to replenish it, you incorporate high carb days or refeeds to get your glycogen stores back in check. So, you know, when you're getting ready for a show over a long period of time, you're depleting your body. Your goal is to, you know, get to as low as the body fat percentage as possible, right? Get as lean as possible, bring that condition they're looking for on the stage. So, you know, I think me personally, I am in a very good spot being 10 days out. I'd say the hardest part of this prep was between 10 and 4 weeks. That's where I really pushed, you know, the low calories, the cardio. And I think now that I'm closer to the condition I need to be, I don't want to lose fullness in my muscles. And, you know, being this condition early, Me and my coach have been working together and incorporating high days to see how my body responds to, you know, a certain amount of carbs. And this is going to be good feedback leading into the show and filling out and peaking for the show properly. So it just mind boggles me that yesterday I had a high day of 400 grams of carbs, around 3,100 calories, and my weight went down. So honestly, like, it's not really a bad thing. It's, you know, it's good that, you know, I did it and getting that feedback that my weight is dropping. It just shows that my body is metabolizing the carbs well and utilizing the carbs well, digesting it well. So we are trying a different approach today where we are aiming for around that 400 grams of carbs, but also adding kind of a cheat meal. At the end of the day, burger and fries, nothing crazy. It's going to be like a clean, like not a fast food spot, but maybe at a restaurant or something. I haven't decided, but these are structured in a way. And, you know, if you pay attention to, you know, how people go into shows, filling up for shows, some people will do, you know, a burger and fries at night, like pancakes in the morning, because, you know, when you're filling out for a show, you do need a lot amount of carbs. In the past, haven't really tried this burger and fries approach. But honestly, just trusting my coach, seeing, and just gonna see how my body responds. So yeah, not complaining about these high days. Like, who's gonna complain about more food? You know, I've been suffering this whole prep. But honestly, these last 2 weeks have been a very smooth process for me in terms of, you know, not as suffering as much. I'd expect like 2-3 weeks out, you know, I'd be like depleting, like high amounts of cardio. But like I mentioned before, since I, you know, did it earlier, got conditioned pretty early, got ahead of schedule, we're able to incorporate these high days and, you know, get good feedback leading into the show. So yeah, these last couple weeks have been very smooth for me. You know, like, been the smoothest, most enjoyable prep so far. But yeah, I'm gonna, you know, enjoy the food today, see how my body responds, how I wake up looking tomorrow. And then, you know, we're doing, so me and my coach are doing check-ins every single day, every single morning, and he kind of tells me what my protocols are. So yeah, just sitting in between meals 1 and 2. If you know the prep life, it's literally just eat, sleep, train, cardio. And when you're not doing any of that, you're literally just waiting in between meals. So every 2 to 3 hours, I'm eating 5 meals a day currently. And yeah, just gonna watch some, you know, some YouTube, got CG on the screen. And I'm gonna take you guys to meal 2.
All right, guys, I'm about to make meal 2 and just look what happened. So yeah, that's great. Gotta clean this, really not in the mood to do that, but my clumsy ass dropped it all over the floor. Love that. So you guys know, we always go to the exact number. If you go over, you're cheating on your diet. That's just how it goes. But yep, right on the money. 225 grams of white rice here.
Thing I do want to say is refeed days aren't cheat days. They are structured, they have purpose behind it. I know I am having a cheat meal later, but I am taking into account my overall macros. But yeah, refeed days, like I mentioned before, they have purpose. They are meant to speed up your metabolism, restore glycogen. So yeah, mostly just eating the same meals I do on a daily basis, just in higher quantity in terms of the carbs. So like my rice, oats, cream of rice, you know, potatoes. But yeah, so today we're just I'm eating pretty much the same thing I eat, been eating all prep. Just adding in a little burger and fries to see how my body reacts later tonight. That is a cheat meal, not a cheat day. This isn't a cheat day. Still need to have some discipline for today. So yeah, meal 2 going down. All right, guys, so meal 2 is done. So actually right now, so you've probably been wondering, in all my videos, I've been wearing a hat, wearing my hood, like my hair has just been a disaster lately. So I'm getting a haircut today. I have been rocking the blonde for months now. Gonna get it redone today. Also planning a haircut for next week before I leave to Houston for the show. You know, it's important, gotta look good on stage, and if you know me, I'm big on my haircuts. But yeah, so gonna get the hair done today, head back for meal three, which is gonna be my pre-workout meal, and then we're gonna head back today as well. So I expect to get a crazy pump today with all these carbs. And
all right guys, the fit for today. Some late. Let's do an ab check. Why not?
He was stabbing. LSD hit his brain. Yeah, that nigga, he been tapping. I just got your shorty. Yeah, my niggas, we been tapping.
Alright, guys, I just got back from the barber. As you can see, the full blonde, got the fresh cut. So, I actually didn't fade the size, what I usually do. But this is strategic. So, today is 10 days out. I fly out 2 days before the show. So, I'm gonna get a haircut that morning and fade the sides just so I have a fresh cut for the show. But, yeah, that's what we're looking like. Yeah, that took longer than I thought actually. So the last meal I had was 4 hours ago. So I'm honestly fucking starving. So it's gonna make my meal three, which is my pre-workout meal. And then yeah, head over to the gym. All right guys, so this is gonna be meal three, my pre-workout meal. One of my favorite meals. You know, you're not a real bodybuilder unless you like cream of rice. So we got 90 grams of cream of rice, 50 grams of frozen blueberries, 20 grams of almond butter, and some cinnamons. But yeah, man, I'm so full of energy today. You know, these high carbs have been treating me well. But yeah, I can't wait to get in the gym and just fuck up my back, because 10 days out, I'm literally have that mindset that, you know, every workout counts. Can, you know, I only have maybe 2 or 3 back days left. So I'm not sure I'm gonna film it just cause, you know, this is a full day of eating video. Maybe I'll get some clips, or maybe some clips of the pump or whatever. But yeah, gonna eat this, digest a bit, then head over to the gym.
Ever so slightly.
Little diet tip.
Right, you're 6 days out.
Use a tiny ass spoon. So you have more bites and it feels like you're eating it for longer. I just want to share that with you guys. Major key.
Alright guys, just got back home from the gym. I hit a solid back and bicep session. Didn't film, but I'll throw up some clips I took on my phone. Yeah, I liked how my back was looking. The V taper is really coming in. My waist is really slimming down. So this is my post-workout meal. It is 225 grams of rice, 200 grams of potatoes, 6 ounces of tilapia, and 50 grams of asparagus. So yeah, honestly, I'm freaking starving. Gonna eat this, and then later we get to enjoy our little cheat meal tonight of burger and fries. So yeah, I'll list the macros up on the screen for this right now, and I'll also list up the macros, my total macros for the day before the cheat meal. So those are gonna be my macros. I'm not exactly sure how many calories or what the macros are gonna be for my cheat meal, but I believe roughly it'll
total my calories up to 4,000. I don't know, but yeah, I'm going to enjoy this, and then I'm definitely going to take you guys through my cheat meal tonight. So yeah, I'll see you guys then.
All right, guys, so it is about that time. So cheat meal is about to go down. So actually, after my post-workout meal, I somehow knocked the fuck out. Knocked out for like an hour. But yeah, so that kind of ruined my plan. So, you know, this is a big deal for me. I've been looking at burger places all over the city, you know, good burger restaurants, and even asking my friends, like, you know, where should I go? But yeah, so my original plan was to go to Joey's. So Joey's is a restaurant, one of my favorite restaurants here in downtown. I know they have a solid burger, they have a solid sweet potato fries, but they close at 1. So I called them, it's 12 a.m. right now, so I called them, I'm like, can I still come in and sit down? And they said no. So I was like, fuck, what am I gonna do? So what I ultimately decided is that I'm gonna go to this spot that's literally like right near my building. I could walk there in like 30 seconds. It's called Fox and Fiddle. So never eaten there before. Never heard anyone talk crazy about it or anything, but it's honestly the only place that's open right now, and hopefully, you know, they have a solid burger and fries. Like, I'm taking a huge gamble here. Like I said, this is a big deal for me. This is my first cheat meal. Like, throughout this whole prep, I haven't had a my coach gave me one cheat meal, and it was a steak and fries, like nothing crazy. But today he said I could have a burger and fries. So this is like my real actual like cheap first cheat meal of this prep. So I want it to be like a good experience, right? So hopefully I don't fuck up by going to this place. I hope it's good. Yeah, so I actually, you know, I was asking friends, you know, if they wanted to go out and stuff. But all my friends are either dieting or it's too last minute. Plus it's 12 a.m. and who's trying to get a burger and fries at 12 a.m. But yeah, I'm gonna be on my solo dolo. I'm gonna enjoy it regardless. And yeah, I'm definitely gonna take you guys through it. So, you know, got the fit on, got look my cozy vibes on. And yeah, I'm gonna go enjoy this cheat meal and then bring you guys with me. So, see you guys there.
What's your most popular burger? You just have one burger?
Yeah, I just have the one.
Okay, how big is it?
It's a 6 ounce.
6 ounce. Okay. Okay, cool. How about your sweet potato fries? How big is it?
Potato fries?
Yeah.
They're $7. They're like a potato fries.
Yes. So the burger and the sweet potato fries. Yeah. So no pickles on there. What toppings is on there?
So it has lettuce, sweet pickles, and then you put like a mac sauce on it. Or you can add like tomato or jalapeno.
Do you have bacon and cheese?
You can add bacon.
Yeah.
Okay,
I'll add bacon as well. Yeah. What veggies do you like?
I can add like jalapeno or tomato.
Add onion and add a tomato as well.
And the fries, okay?
Oh, yeah, that's good. Thank you.
Alright, guys, that's what we got. Guys, good portion. Not too much, not too little. We got the burger, the bacon, onion. Oh man, excited for this. Not gonna do sauce, just gonna put some ketchup on top. First bite of the burger going down. Good man.
Alright guys, cheat meal down. Not gonna lie, that was really fucking good. You know, I felt like I took a little gamble just eating at a spot I've never eaten before. But not like, it was actually a really good burger, solid fries. Yeah, just walking home. Yeah, I'm excited to see, you know, how my body looks tomorrow morning. So yeah, that's gonna wrap up today's full day of eating on a refeed day plus a cheat meal. And honestly, hopefully it fills me out, because yeah, 400 carbs didn't work yesterday, so hopefully this does. So but yeah, thanks for watching, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.